I had a lot more than I thought I did. Hey, what's up? I just realized that I don't actually have an intro for any of these videos. You know how some people have like a common intro they do? And they're like, "What's poppin', low gang? It's your boy," like that. Yeah, I don't have that. Willing to take suggestions because I have no clue what I'm doing for that. Anyway, a couple days ago, or maybe like a week and a half ago at this point, I made a video about my new Miles Morales suit. And that kind of did pretty well. You guys liked that? That was awesome. I had planned on the week after that to make a video about all of my spider suits, but Mother Nature decided to absolutely d*** me, and I got sick on my one day off, so I could not for the life of me film on that day. It was hard enough to film TikToks. I even went live on TikTok when I was sick. If you were at that live stream, I deeply apologize, because I was just like coughing all day. Not fun. But I finally have time now to respond to that comment of all of my spider suits. Like I said, I've been cosplaying Spider-Man for a decent amount of time, and I've acquired a good amount of suits. Some really good, some really bad, but I still have all of them here, and I'm gonna go through all of them today, and I'm gonna show you the bad ones I used to have, because yes, I did buy bad ones at first. But then I'm gonna show you all the new ones and the cool ones. If you're an avid follower on all of my other content, you'll recognize most of these, but some you might be surprised I actually have. So I guess let's get into it. I really gotta work on that intro thing.
Okay, so to start off, I'm gonna go through the masks first. I just noticed this is really faded. You see that color, how faded that is? I'm gonna have to repaint that. So this is like my go-to mask, the one I wear in every single video, every TikTok, every YouTube intro, every Q&A video. I don't know why I'm tapping them on the nose. Every single video I wear this one. This is the one that fits me the best and the one that I like the most. It's a combination of two different things. It's the PS4 shell and lenses and Amazing Spider-Man 2 print fabric. The shell itself is 3D printed and the lenses are resin printed. So I think I'm gonna go chronologically and show you guys kind of the process. So what you guys are used to is like face shells like this, the professional ones I use, but I wasn't always this way. My first ever face shell is this guy, and this is a monstrosity, but it is the first ever face shell that I made by hand before I knew anything about Spider-Man cosplay. I took a cereal box, cut it apart, glued it together, formed it around into a face shell shape, and then reattached new lenses onto it. And then obviously over the years, after using it so many times, I had to rebandage it, restrap it with tape, with foam on the inside, all of it. So it is very rough, has the elastic band on the back too, but that's what I started with. So I get a lot of comments on TikTok or a lot of people on my live saying, "I want to cosplay Spider-Man, but I don't have a face shell." Well, you don't technically need to buy one, you can make one. And I've made this out of, like I said, a cereal box, some Bondo, and some hot glue. So if you're dedicated enough, you can make one out of cardboard. I'll leave a link down below to a video that I followed to make this mask, but one day I'll probably make one for you guys to show you how to make your own. Moving down the line, I have my two print costume shells. I have my two Miles Morales fabrics draped over them, but in terms, they're the exact same shell design, the exact same face structure. The only difference is the two lens colors. So obviously I have red for Miles and then black for Peter, or if I'm doing a symbiote, black for the symbiote. So that's what this would be doing. These are the standard ones from print costume. These are what I wear, of course, like I said, for Miles Morales. I don't wear these for any of my Peter Parker suits though. These are only for my Miles Morales or a symbiote suit. But again, just to show you, they're the exact same shell underneath. I have two of them. And the only reason I got two, again, is just because of the different lens colors. The next one we have is another PS4 Spider-Man face shell. However, this one has taken a little bit of damage. This one is a bit different from the first one I wear. Let me grab that first one. So this one is a bit different in the sense of not only the shape, but the material of the shell. This one is much, much heavier, as it is a much nicer plastic underneath, a much heavier duty plastic, and much heavier lenses. These lenses are way heavy. These lenses are very light. What happened with this one is I gave it to a buddy. If you guys remember Spider Homie, I gave it to him to wear for one thing, and he dropped the lens and it cracked. So I had to kind of glue it back together. Since then, it's cracked so many times, I've just given up on the fact that it can be a normal lens, and both the lenses are kind of cracked. So as good of a shell as this is, it is very fragile and I don't wear it very often. The only suit I wear this one for is Spider-Punk. And the reason for that is because the magnets on the top here is where the spikes attach. Spider-Punk is one I haven't done in quite some time. I used to do him for TikTok a lot. The last two that I have are my Amazing Spider-Man 2 shell. This one is much more flexible. This one's very lightweight. It's probably the lightest one I have. It's not a 3D print. It looks more like a vacuum form shell, but it is very, very loose. It has that nice breathability to it. And the lenses in particular are different. So the reason I say I don't use this for Amazing Spider-Man is because look at the difference between these lenses. This one is much more small, uniform, classic Spidey. And this one fits that bug eye shell that you really want for Amazing Spider-Man. I'm probably gonna look to upgrade this in the future because I'm not particularly a fan of this, of how it squeezes. But at the moment, there's no problems with the shell. It works pretty great. And the last one is for a cosplay I have not done yet, but it is a Ben Reilly Scarlet Spider. So I have the lenses already in there and the shell itself. I'm gonna have to go through and get some of the white mesh and put it on the inside of this mask. Since I already did the magnets for this one, I'll have to do the mesh on the inside. But this is for a Ben Reilly Scarlet Spider that I have not done yet. And I bought this one with this one together because he was having a sale on two and I bought them at the same time. And then quick rapid fire the masks I have. I have an extra Amazing Spider-Man 2 mask. And then of course the lenses that I ripped off of that mask when I was toying around with the fabric, seeing what worked. I have a very crappy symbiote mask, which I would never recommend you wear. You can't even get your head in this. Like, that's awful. And the last one I have is my first ever Spider-Man mask. So this is the first ever mask I wore for my first ever cosplay, and it goes over the first ever face shell I wore. So this first face shell and this first mask were my first ever combo into a Spider-Man cosplay. Okay, well, now that I've shown you all the masks I have, now it's time for what you guys have actually been waiting for, all of the suits I have that go along with all of these masks. So I honestly don't even know how many I have, so we're gonna go through together and figure it out.
I had a lot more than I thought I did. I just threw them all down there, but I think I'm gonna go through them in like chronological order of when I think I bought them to the most recent one I have. I'm gonna start with the first one, which I don't physically have in one piece because it's a bunch of pieces, but I'll put a picture of it here. It's my custom street Spider-Man. So it's the first one I ever made. It's when I didn't even have a suit. Like I said, I did the cardboard shell and the mask, and then I combined it with a compression shirt and a hoodie and jeans. So it wasn't even a full suit. After that, I started experimenting into new suits, but there's a picture of that, or a few pictures of that, to show you what that is, because I'm not going to drag every single piece out, because honestly, I don't know where they all are. Okay, so first one is a Spider-Man Far From Home suit. This is a suit that I've actually wanted to have for a pretty long time, but in a good condition. This is not a good condition. I don't know if you can tell based on how I'm holding it now, but this is not very good fabric. It is incredibly loose. It is not too strong. The color does not hold in any way. Like, you can see my whole hand through there. The color doesn't hold. It's very thin. And the fingers are just struggling at the moment. But the reason I bought the Far From Home suit is because when I saw Far From Home, I really wanted the suit, but didn't know where to get a good suit. So I bought a really cheap one to wear. And that was that. I don't have a face shield or mask to go with it, but I use this one because it's the homecoming lenses. It's just a different shade of red, so it's a bit tricky to wear this as a full suit. I don't ever use this as a full cosplay because, like I said, it's not really a good suit, but it is on the list for a good suit eventually. I'm gonna try all the suits on at the end of the video. I'm just gonna rapid fire through them right now. Second one is same kind of deal, but with PS4 suit. This one's a bit better texture. It's a little bit more silky. It has that Lycra feel to it, but again, it's still kind of bad. It still doesn't hold the color through particularly well, but it does a lot better than the Far From Home suit. So this one's already a bit better. However, what I've noticed about this one is it has a particularly bad frog arm effect. If I put it on, the underarm has the frog arm, and we don't like that. This one, again, is a crappier suit I bought off of like AliExpress, like really cheap, really quick, when PS4 came out and I really wanted to wear the suit. I also did, when I was learning airbrushing, a really crappy, you see that chest line, that, yeah, that's not supposed to be there. My dumb ass just airbrushed it in because I thought I was so cool airbrushing stuff. Yeah, that was a poor choice on my part. Again, this is another suit that I want to have a full upgraded version of. Now, this one might shock a few people that I've never put it on, but I do have the black suit Spider-Man from the comics itself. I have a symbiote suit, but again, just like the previous two, it's a cheap build. It's not good. It was from a cheap site. And again, it doesn't hold the color all too well. Very light, very thin, not too good quality. And the worst part about this one, the attached mask. So you see that? So when I was explaining the Spider-Man suit choices, this is what the attached mask means. It means what I'm wearing now is a detached mask. This would be attached. So when you put it on, the mask is like a frontwards hood and you have to like crawl your way in. It's not a fun time. This one has no facial, but if I pair it with facial lenses, it might work. All right, we're getting a little bit closer into the better suits that I own. For Amazing Spider-Man 2, I actually own two of these suits. And the reason for that is simple. One is expensive, one is cheap. When I was planning the Amazing Spider-Man 2 suit, I bought a cheap version of it very quick off of those crappy sites to see what it looked like, to see how it fit, to see if I liked the design, and to see if I liked how it looked on my body. When I bought this suit, I was a lot smaller, so I did not like how it looked. So I never did Amazing Spider-Man, and I trashed it. But after about a year of working better in my physical health and that stuff, I went back to it and decided to bite the bullet and get a good suit and just see what happened. This one is much stronger. It holds the form. Your color stays. It's got a screen printed emblem on the front and the back. It's got soles on the bottom and kung fu shoes on the inside. And it's the ultra thick Lycra. So it's the thickest suit that I own and it feels great. This one is probably one of my favorite, if not my favorite, to put on, because I love that movie so much. Moving into more of a familiar face, we have Miles Morales from Into the Spider-Verse. I'm sorry, I almost said Across the Spider-Verse. This is Into the Spider-Verse. This suit is paired obviously with the hoodie, shorts, jacket, shoes combo with the belt as well to do the streetwear version. I wanted to do the hoodie version. I wanted to do the leap of faith version. So that's what I did. I bought this suit, bought all the other pieces, put it together and wore it. And this, like I said, has kind of been like my intro into the Spider-Man cosplay world with this suit. So Miles Morales and Into the Spider-Verse holds a really close place in my heart for that suit itself, along with that movie. That movie just is amazing. Probably one of my top 5 favorite movies of all time. That being said, this suit has taken its toll and has a lot of problems. The fingers are pretty much completely toast. Those are gone. The wrist zippers are busted open, so I have to wear the suit with the hoodie so it hides the zipper. There's a hole in the back of the neck, and the neck zipper doesn't even unzip, so I have to like condom squeeze my head through. The feet are brutal, but these are fine because I wear the shoes on over them. This is one that most people would probably know me for, is the Spider-Verse Miles Morales suit. One of my favorite suits to wear too. Now, if you've been following me on TikTok since the start of TikTok, you'll recognize this guy. But if you're newer on my content and you just kind of started following me in the past year, you have no clue that I ever did this guy. I put this one together and I made it, and I don't think I've seen many people do this suit. And I finally want to do a photo shoot with him, but I have Spider-Punk. So Spider-Punk, the way this suit works is exactly the same as my Amazing Spider-Man 2 suit. It's all of the same options with the exception of the feet. Because the feet, I wear red Chucks over them to give that punk look. So now, not only do I have the suit for Spider-Punk, but I went through and made the entire Spider-Punk outfit. And when I say made, I actually mean I made it. I bought a denim jacket, cut the sleeves, hand punched in every single one of these spikes, and painted on that on the back of it. You can see it's hand painted on. I don't quite know what went wrong in my head when I spent so much time, effort, and money building Spider-Punk. To when he was finally done, I just said, all right, later, and never did anything with him. And like I said, that was back when I was a little bit smaller. After spending a year getting into better shape, I'm excited to put that on to see how it looks and hopefully plan a photo shoot with him. Because a lot of people do request Spider-Punk, and I always say I have Spider-Punk, I just don't ever wear him. So maybe it's time to bring him back. And of course, if you saw the last videos, the most recent suit is Miles Morales Across the Spider-Verse. I don't need to go into depth on this one because you guys saw the unboxing video. So, with that being said, with every suit being explained, now it's time to try all of them on and see how they fit. Okay, so I think that's all of my spider suits. If I didn't show it directly in this video, like the first ever street custom Spider-Man or the full dressed up Leap of Faith Miles Morales suit, I'll include links to posts on those and also images here or with when I showed those suits, just to show you everything I've done. But yeah, I hope that gives you a little bit of insight into all of the spider suits I've ever had and to show you kind of the misfires I took over the years, all of the bad ones I had that I had to get to in order to get to the better ones that I wear now. Like I said, this is the most recent one and I'll be taking it on a photo shoot probably next week, if not the week after that. So be sure to stay tuned on Instagram to see all of those photos come to light with Miles and Gwen. But as always, everyone have a great day. Peace and love, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!